I'm Rosemary Gladstar. I'm an herbalist, author, and a lifetime lover of plants. I first started working and studying with plants over 40 years ago, and I'm delighted and honored to be sharing some of what I've learned with you.
I would like to welcome Rosemary Gladstar. She's literally a star figure in the field of modern herbalism, internationally renowned for her technical knowledge and stewardship in the global herbalist community. Mm-hmm. She's been learning, teaching, and writing about herbs for over 40 years. She's written 11 books and co-founded Traditional Medicinal Teas. One of the books is the extensive home study course, The Science and Art of Herbalism. Rosemary really is a pioneer in the herbal movement and has been called the godmother of American herbalism. We're here today at Sage Mountain Herbal Retreat Center, a 500-acre botanical sanctuary in central Vermont. Thank you, Rosemary, for having us. It's such an honor.
Thanks, Helen. It's great. It's great to be here. It's great to be at home.
So can you please tell us a little bit about how you started working with the plants?
Oh, yes, I can. I always love telling this story. I was one of those children who had the good fortune to grow up in a large family, and having my grandmother and my grandparents, actually both sets lived near us when we were growing up. And one of my grandmothers, my grandmother Mary Kikanoff, was very knowledgeable about plants. She was an herbalist in the old sense of the word, where that's what she used for healing. It was at a time when people did use plants, so it wasn't that it was unusual even. Mm-hmm. But she had a profound knowledge. She was also a survivor of the Armenian genocide. So she brought with her a deep love and a profound respect for the plants. She used to tell me when we were children growing up that it was her deep love of God and her knowledge of the plants that saved her life. And so really, from the time I was a small child, I was nurtured in this love of plants, and it rooted deeply. I was one of those people that I think I was chosen by the plants, many of my herbal friends say, you know, to work with them. And so it's nourished me my whole life. So I would say it's a love that I perhaps even came to this planet with, but definitely was nurtured by the teachings of my elder, and particularly my grandmother. Mm.
And you took those teachings and started a school in California.
Well, first of all, in the early 1970s, I opened up a small herb store, which mm-hmm. is, I'm happy to say, is still there. It's still in the little town that I grew up in. And I started teaching, actually, from my home, because at that time, people really didn't know much. There were hardly any resources about herbs. Mm-hmm. Herbalism had gone deeply underground. And so I started teaching classes, and as the years went by, people wanted to know more and more. So I opened up the herb school in response to a need that my community had. And it was very fortunate for me, because I got to learn from some of the best of my contemporary herbalists, of my friends who were also had been called to herbs and were using plants.
And can you tell us about the home study course, so the science and art of herbalism?
Well, yes, that course evolved out of, again, out of the need of a greater community. We had a lot of people who weren't able to come to herb school. You know, they weren't able to travel across the country, and they wanted to. And there really, at that time, it was back in the early 1980s, actually, when I started that course, there weren't any other courses. So what I did is I put together this course, actually, to help train people, to teach them about herbalism who didn't have schools or teachers in their areas.
And how did you design the course?
Well, I designed it actually after my apprentice programs. I used to run these 10-month apprentice programs where people would come, small groups of people would come and study with me for a weekend a month for 10 months. Mm-hmm. And there were lots of components. It was about lots of hands-on stuff, mm-hmm. which is hard to do in a home study course, but which I felt was vital and essential to herbalism. So, and I also trained it, I also structured it very much like, you know, at a day at the herb school, a day at the apprentice program, where there were several different components. So there was herb identification, or there was herb preparation, and there was studying a body system. So I took each one of the lessons. The course was broken down into 10 lessons, mm-hmm. sort of mimicking again my 10-month apprentice program. And then each one of those lessons was broken down into segments that involved hands-on research and studying the body systems. And it seemed to work really well. It gives people a great diversity each time they open up a lesson, mm-hmm. and it touches all the aspects of herbalism, from, you know, the practical aspect to the research aspect to the scientific, a little of the scientific. Mm-hmm. This is really designed for beginner, intermediate students, people who are just becoming interested in plants, and it's really about home healthcare It's not a clinical course designed for practitioners to study and become, you know, to be practitioners of herbal medicine. There are some good courses available. This is more designed for home healthcare and lays a strong foundation for people to continue their studies if
they
choose.
It really is excellent. And now you have an online offering. Can you tell us a little bit about that and how it was envisioned?
Well, it would never have come from me. I'm really like the most computer unsavvy person. I do work on the computer. Mm-hmm. It's mostly Word and it's writing and I don't love it. But it was my son. He is my webmaster and he's helped me out for many, many years with my websites and helping me with all aspects of the computer. And he kept hounding me, literally. You have to put this online. There are so many people who work online. And I kept saying to him, well, later. I said that for a few years. And finally, one day, I just kind of threw up my hands in exasperation. It was actually when you came along. And I said, go for it, do it. And so my son, Jason, who's actually written up in some of my books and in my lessons, he was a young boy who went with me on those horseback trips and was learning all the plants. So he's really quite a good herbalist as well. But he took the course and really set up a beautiful online campus, which we have many students now who are really doing well and loving it. So for me, it's wonderful. Because, again, it's just the teaching, seeing the people embrace herbalism and to bring it into their homes and to start to become healthier using nature and natural means. It's really very, very rewarding for me and exciting. So thank you, Jason, for, you know, really actually envisioning it and then making it practical and real, because I know there's a lot of people who are really happy.
Thank you for providing the information and the opportunity. It's a great privilege to work on the course and to continue to make it better and offer more lessons, more video, more audio, and more interactivity. It's been great success and look forward to moving forward. We've got a lot of good ideas and plans for it.
We do.
That's great. So that's excellent.
And so there's the printed version and then there's the online version. And I think that the difference between the two would be that the printed version would be for that person who might not want to spend a lot of time on the computer, who loves the printed binder, which is beautiful, and have those lessons printed for you to take notes. And the online version offers a very interactive, vibrant community. We have forums that we've set up for the students to ask questions.
That's
we have teachers, myself, and a few others who respond to those questions. We've posted videos. We have an extensive video and audio library that continues to grow. Herb of the Month, which we've done, and we've featured some teachers recently. And we have a very personalized touch with the students and them being able to reach out to us and answer questions.
Right. I think that is one of the beauties of this course. And, you know, I've had so many people write in after they've graduated from the 10 lessons and say, you know, it's a course that's really changed my life. And I used to wonder, you know, how can a correspondence course that people are doing at home, sometimes doing alone, sometimes doing with their family, how can that be life-changing? But it's the nature of the study. Mm-hmm. Plants are life-changing. They almost trick you into falling into them, really, and they take you someplace really deep. And yes, they do impact us on a physical level through our health and healing, but it's much deeper than that. And I feel they're so essential for people right now because they connect us with nature. They remind us of something that's really old. It's such an ancient and old tradition. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it's been really exciting, and I'm very happy to see the online course doing so well.
And thank you for your your generosity and the fact that you offer both as a combined option for those people who are interested in the printed version and the online version.
Yeah.
I feel that that's such an excellent offering, that combined, you know, combining the printed and the online version. So, well, thank you for creating this home study course.
Thank you, Helen. And I'd also like to just introduce Helen. Helen is an amazing herbalist. She has her own herb farm and makes her own herbal products that are very well known in Vermont. And she's our online educational director. She actually is the person that helps to correct the homework and oversees the course and works very closely with my son, Jason. So thank you both for really bringing the correspondence course to the next level. So thank you.
You're welcome. It really is our pleasure. It's been an honor to do this work. So thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for having us here today.
Sometimes I feel feel far.